EU chief denies disinformation report was watered down for China. The full interview with Ursula von der Leyen airs on Amanpour Monday 2 p.m. Eastern Time 8 p.m. set 5 p.m. HKT on CNN International, and on Monday evening on PBS across America, local listings vary. London European Commission President Ursula von der Leyen has denied allegations that the EU watered down a report on coronavirus disinformation after being pressured from China. The allegations arose after Politico Europe quoted an excerpt from a draft version of the report on April 21, which explicitly accused China of running a global disinformation campaign to deflect blame for the outbreak of the pandemic and improve its international image. The report appears to have been delayed, and when published on April 24, the excerpt on China had been replaced with a watered-down version. In an interview with CNN's Christiane Amanpour, who asked von der Leyen if China had pressured the EU to change the report's language, the EU chief denied the allegation and swiftly diverted her answer to the issue of lessons learned from the pandemic. "No, this is an independent report done by the external service, and indeed what I think what we will have to do, I was talking about lessons learned. If there's one lesson we've learned, that is we did not have robust data," she said. When pressed again and asked whether the EU was self-censoring, von der Leyen denied the accusation and turned to the issue of unfit medical material coming out of China as an example of the EU being unafraid to criticize Beijing. "No, not at all. What I think is important is that we have made very clear our position. And you know that there were many critical voices concerning material coming from China that was not fit for purpose. So, there are points when there are critics that have to be issued at the level of the European Union. It happens, and we do that, and there are other points that go well," she said. After the report's publication, the New York Times cited EU diplomatic sources saying that China had put pressure on the bloc. The Times also published parts of a leaked email that showed how the draft report was on the verge of publication when Esther Osorio, a senior advisor to the European Union's top diplomat, Josep Borrell, ordered it be held. When CNN reached out to Osorio for comment, a spokesperson from the EU's Foreign Affairs and Security Policy responded, saying that the emails published by the New York Times article were reported out of context. The spokesperson, Virginie Badu-Henriksen, did not respond to the question of whether Osorio personally called for the draft to be held. She denied that the report's language had been changed and said, rather, that the original document cited by Politico was not actually a draft report. The allegations seen in some media refer to the fact that there are two different documents. 1. The Information Environment Assessment is a document for internal information and consumption. The other one, the EIA's special report, is for public consumption. The public reports often contain similar information to the internal documents, as it was the case with the report published on Friday and the last Information Environment Assessment, she said. The original excerpt explicitly accusing China of a disinformation campaign was replaced with a softened sentence: official and state-backed sources from various governments, including Russia and, to a lesser extent, China, have continued to widely target conspiracy narratives and disinformation. Borrell faced questions from European lawmakers on Thursday over whether the document was delayed and then revised. Did China put pressure? "Look, it's clear and evident that China expressed their concerns," Borrell said during the specially convened meeting of the European Parliament's Foreign Affairs Committee. "I can assure you that no changes have been introduced to the report published last week to allay the concerns of a third party, in this case China." China's foreign affairs spokesman Zhang Shuang would not confirm that China had pressured the EU. China is the EU's second largest trading partner, and the EU is China's biggest trading partner. China and the EU trade on average over 1 billion euros, $1.1 billion, a day. EU's disjointed response did a lot of harm. The pressure on von der Leyen comes as she faces pointed criticism over the bloc's failures to establish an early coordinated coronavirus response. The first coronavirus case arrived on the continent in France on January 24, according to the European Centre for Disease Prevention and Control, yet it wasn't until March 2 that the Commission even created a coronavirus emergency response group. A few days later, as Italy faced crippling medical shortages and a climbing death toll, member states, including Germany, France and the Czech Republic, banned the export of medical protective gear to avoid shortages at home, and no EU country initially responded to Italy's call for aid via the bloc's emergency mechanism. At the beginning of the crisis it was difficult, because member states started to withdraw into themselves, and we had border closures, and we had export bans, von der Leyen told Amanpour. This looking inwards and trying to protect their own people is a reflex that is understandable. It did a lot of harm, but it was understandable. It took a few days, and then everybody realized that we can only fight this virus together, she added. US government won't participate in EU-led global response. Von der Leyen also spoke to Amanpour about a vaccine pledge event organized by the Commission, which will begin on Monday. Known as the Coronavirus Global Response, the event will attempt to kickstart international cooperation by getting G20 governments to pool resources for the development of coronavirus treatments and vaccines. The only way to fight this virus is to find a vaccine, and not only to find and produce the vaccine, but to make sure it is deployed in every corner in the world. This is a big global endeavor, and we need money for that, von der Leyen said. When pressed on the US government's decision not to take part in the pledge effort, von der Leyen said she still hoped the country would consider joining the effort. Well, the United States are doing a lot domestically, they are informed about our global initiative, and I hope that, in one or the other way, they decide to join, she said. Michigan State Police prevent protesters from entering the chamber of the Michigan House of Representatives on Thursday, April 30. The protesters are unhappy with the state's stay-at-home order. Governor Gretchen Whitmer recently extended the order through May 15, though restrictions were relaxed, so some businesses could reopen. This aerial photo shows surfers accessing Sydney's Tamarama Beach through new fencing on Wednesday, April 29. Several Sydney beaches reopened for exercise only. U.S. Vice President Mike Pence visits Dennis Nelson, a patient who survived the coronavirus and was going to give blood, during a tour of the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota, on Tuesday, April 28. Pence chose not to wear a face mask during the tour despite the facility's policy that's been in place since April 13. Pence told reporters that he wasn't wearing a mask because he's often tested for coronavirus. A barber wears protective equipment as he cuts a customer's hair in Lausanne, Switzerland, on Monday, April 27. After recovering from the coronavirus, British Prime Minister Boris Johnson returned to work on April 27. Health workers at a coronavirus testing center in New Delhi attend to a colleague who fainted due to exhaustion on April 27. Families walk along a boulevard in Barcelona, Spain, on Sunday, April 26. The government now allows children to go out once a day, for 1 hour, within about half a mile of their homes, with one adult who lives with them. Up to three kids can go with each adult. A muezzin, the person at a mosque who calls Muslims to daily prayers, reads the Quran at a mosque in Gaza City after Ramadan began on Friday, April 24. Patrick van der Lubbe waves from a boom lift to his 88-year-old father, Henk, at his father's nursing home in Gouda, Netherlands, on April 24. Patrick had not seen his father in more than 4 weeks. Protesters shout slogans against Lebanese Central Bank Governor Riyad Salem as they block Hamra Street in Beirut, Lebanon, on April 23. Anti-government protesters have been demonstrating in Beirut as they continue to endure one of its worst-ever economic crises. A boy plays hopscotch at his home in A Coruña, Spain, on April 23. A dentist wears protective equipment while treating a patient in Den Bosch, Netherlands, on April 22. Biology teachers prepare to hold an exam at a secondary school in Berlin on April 22. A volunteer in Yangon, Myanmar, spreads calcium oxide on a road to help prevent the spread of the coronavirus on April 22. Migrants wave from balconies at a hotel in Kriniti, Greece, on April 21. The shelter, which hosts 470 asylum seekers, was placed in isolation after a pregnant resident tested positive for the novel coronavirus. A man disinfects a ceiling lamp at the Obanija Mosque in Sarajevo, Bosnia and Herzegovina, on April 21. A nurse holds a newborn baby, wearing a face shield as a protective measure, at a maternity facility in Jakarta, Indonesia, on April 21. Health workers at Madrid's La Paz Hospital hold a minute of silence to remember Joaquin Diaz, the hospital's chief of surgery who died because of the coronavirus. A woman applauds from the balcony of her Paris home to show support for healthcare workers on April 20. A healthcare worker stands in a Denver street on April 19 to counter-protest the hundreds of people who were demanding that stay-at-home orders be lifted. Mayor's office workers wear protective suits as they conduct a census in a Bogota, Colombia neighborhood on April 19. They were trying to find out how many families needed to be provided with food. The class of 2020 tosses hats into the air at the Air Force Academy graduation in Colorado Springs, Colorado. A woman sticks her tongue out of a torn mask at a Reopen Maryland rally outside the State House in Annapolis, Maryland, on April 18. Residents in multiple states have been protesting stay-at-home orders. Newly married Tyler and Karen Suitors embrace following their marriage ceremony in Arlington, Virginia, on April 18. The Rev. Andrew Merrow and his wife, Cameron, were the only other attendees at the ceremony, which was held at St. Mary's Episcopal Church. Abed Kankan cuts a customer's hair outdoors in Malmo, Sweden, on April 17. Two women walk to rent a small paddle boat by the Vltava River in Prague, Czech Republic, on April 17. Cars sit at a newly opened drive-in cinema in Dortmund, Germany, on April 17. It's in front of a former blast furnace. Funeral workers in Manaus, Brazil, prepare the grave of a woman who is suspected to have died from the coronavirus. A member of the Don Bosco Foundation delivers food from the Fraternitas Project, which serves vulnerable families in Seville, Spain, on April 16. Police officers try on personal protective equipment in Amritsar, India, on April 16. Workers in Nairobi, Kenya, fumigate the streets and the stalls of the City Park Market on April 15. Novice Buddhist monks wear face shields at the Malilakaram Educational Institute in Bangkok, Thailand, on April 15. A woman sits on a bench at an empty metro station in Prague, Czech Republic, on April 15. Health workers in Barcelona, Spain, acknowledge people who are showing their support from their balconies and windows. South Korean election officials sort out parliamentary ballots at a gymnasium in Seoul on April 15. Workers from the garment sector in Dhaka, Bangladesh, block a road during a protest demanding payment of unpaid wages. A woman meets with her son in a quarantiner, a container devised to allow people to visit each other without risking the spread of coronavirus, at a care center in Utrecht, Netherlands, on April 14. Firefighters transfer a patient from an ambulance in Montpellier, France, on April 14. A cemetery worker pauses while digging graves at the San Vicente Cemetery in Cordoba, Argentina, on April 14. Workers produce protective face masks at a new factory near Tehran, Iran, on April 14. Protesters stand outside the State House atrium in Columbus, Ohio, on April 13, to voice their opposition to stay-at-home orders. About 100 protesters assembled outside the building during Governor Mike DeWine's weekday update on the state's response to the pandemic. Medical workers in Istanbul clap for 107-year-old Havahan Kardeniz as she is discharged from the hospital on April 13. She had just recovered from the coronavirus. People in Seoul, South Korea, listen to a speech from Hwang Kyo-an, who is campaigning for the upcoming parliamentary elections. A flower shop employee destroys unsold flowers in St. Petersburg, Russia, on April 13. A police officer requests that people return to their homes during a gathering that marked the Biscuit Jatra festival in Bhaktapur, Nepal. A doctor in a protective chamber tests a patient for coronavirus at a walk-in kiosk in Chennai, India, on April 13. Musicians play their instruments for a retirement home in Karben, Germany, on April 13. A woman covers herself with plastic as heavy rain falls outside a New York hospital on April 13. People in Jerusalem attend the funeral of Eliyahu Bakshi Doran, Israel's former chief rabbi who died from coronavirus complications. In Rio de Janeiro, the Christ the Redeemer statue was illuminated to make Christ look like a doctor on April 12. Pedro Apica, founder of the Akamaso Association, conducts the traditional Easter Mass in a granite quarry while maintaining social distancing in Antananarivo, Madagascar, on April 12. Bodies are stored in a vacant room at Sinai Grace Hospital in Detroit. Two sources told CNN that at least one room, which is typically used for studies on sleeping habits, was used to store bodies because the morgue was full and morgue staff did not work at night. A couple stands in a park along the Yangtze River in Wuhan, China. Priest in charge Angie Smith uses her phone to broadcast an Easter service from a churchyard in Hartley, Witney, England, on April 12. Children wave to a person dressed as the Easter Bunny during a neighborhood parade in Haverford, Pennsylvania, on April 10. Health workers in Leyen, Spain, cry during a memorial for a co-worker who died because of the coronavirus. Volunteers spray disinfectant in a favela in Rio de Janeiro on April 10. Bodies are buried on New York's Hard Island on April 9. New York City officials say that Hard Island, which for decades has been used as the final resting place for people who died unclaimed, will also be used for unclaimed coronavirus victims. A healthcare worker holds the hand of a coronavirus patient being moved at a hospital near Barcelona, Spain, on April 9. Service boats spray water in London to show support for healthcare workers on April 9. Employees of Hyundai Card, a credit card company, sit behind protective screens as they eat in an office cafeteria in Seoul, South Korea, on April 9. People wait in their cars for the San Antonio Food Bank to begin food distribution on April 9. A worker disinfects a carved cross at the Salt Cathedral in Zipaquirá, Colombia, on April 8. A cake shop employee in Athens, Greece, prepares chocolate Easter bunnies with face masks on April 8. Californian Sarah and Aaron Sanders, along with their children, use video conferencing to celebrate a Passover Seder with other family members on April 8. A medical staff member from China's Jilin Province, center, cries while hugging nurses from Wuhan on April 8. Wuhan was reopening its borders after 76 days. Cars in Wuhan line up to leave at a highway toll station. Rabbi Yaakov Kotlarski places Passover Seder to-go packages into a car trunk in Arlington Heights, Illinois, on April 7. A woman in London shows her support for British Prime Minister Boris Johnson on April 7. Johnson was hospitalized after his coronavirus symptoms worsened, according to his office. A voter checks in to cast a ballot in Kenosha, Wisconsin, on April 7. The state was going through with its presidential primary despite the pandemic. A man is sprayed with disinfectant prior to going to a market in Tirana, Albania, on Monday, April 6. Izzy, left, and Tibby wear ventilated dog masks in Philadelphia on April 6. People wait in line to bury loved ones at a cemetery in Guayaquil, Ecuador, on April 6. In some parts of the overwhelmed city, bodies have been left on the streets. Police detain a doctor in Quetta, Pakistan, who was among dozens of healthcare workers protesting a lack of personal protective equipment on April 6. A Catholic priest sprinkles holy water on devotees during Palm Sunday celebrations in Quezon City, Philippines, on Sunday, April 5. People shine lights from their balcony during a nationwide candlelight vigil in Bangalore, India, on April 5. A woman in Glasgow, Scotland, watches Britain's Queen Elizabeth II give a television address regarding the coronavirus pandemic. Paramilitary members unload provisions in Kampala, Uganda, on Saturday, April 4. It was the first day of government food distribution for people affected by the nation's lockdown. A police officer wearing a coronavirus-themed outfit walks in a market in Chennai, India, to raise awareness about social distancing. A woman in Moscow cooks while watching Russian President Vladimir Putin address the nation over the coronavirus pandemic. The hashtag #StayHome is projected onto the Matterhorn mountain that straddles Switzerland and Italy on April 1. The mountain was illuminated by Swiss artist Jerry Hofstadter, who is transforming buildings, monuments and landscapes all over the world to raise awareness during the pandemic. Volunteers load food bags on a truck to deliver them to low-income families in Panama City, Panama, on April 1. Designer Friedrich Jorzig adjusts a mannequin wearing a wedding dress and a face mask at her store in Berlin on March 31. People pray next to the grave of musician Robson de Souza Lopes after his burial in Manaus, Brazil, on March 31. According to authorities at the Amazonas Health Secretary, the 43-year-old died after being diagnosed with the novel coronavirus. Chris Lindbergh hands out a free lunch to a truck driver at a rest area along Interstate 10 in Saucaton, Arizona, on March 31. The Arizona Trucking Association was giving away 500 Dilly's Deli lunches to show its appreciation for truck drivers who have been delivering medical supplies, food and other necessities during the coronavirus pandemic. The USNS Comfort, a Navy hospital ship, reaches New York City on March 30. Another hospital ship is in Los Angeles. Both will take some of the pressure off medical facilities that are strained because of the coronavirus pandemic. An emergency field hospital is constructed in New York Central Park on March 30. Farmers deliver vegetables to a customer in St. George's-sur-Cher, France, on March 29. People listen from their homes as priests conduct Sunday Mass from a church roof in Rome on March 29. Georgi David Jablonovski and his bride, Timia, are joined by close relatives during their wedding ceremony in Miskolc, Hungary, on March 28. Because of the coronavirus, engaged couples across the globe have had to rethink their walks down the aisle. A worker fixes partitions at a quarantine center in Guwahati, India, on March 28. Devices used in diagnosing the coronavirus are inspected in Cheongju, South Korea, on March 27. The devices were being prepared for testing kits at the biodiagnostic company South Dakota Biosensor. A student does homework in Bratislava, Slovakia, on March 27. Schools have been shut down across the world, and many children have been receiving their lessons online. A National Guard truck sprays disinfectant in Caracas, Venezuela, on March 27. People wearing face masks walk near the USNS Mercy after the Navy hospital ship arrived in the Los Angeles area to assist local hospitals dealing with the coronavirus pandemic. Pope Francis prays in an empty St. Peter's Square on March 27. Coffins carrying coronavirus victims are stored in a warehouse in Ponte San Pietro, Italy, on March 26. They would be transported to another area for cremation. Members of Iran's Revolutionary Guard prepare to take part in disinfecting the city of Tehran on March 25. Lydia Hassebrook attends a ballet class from her home in New York on March 25. People visit the Beijing Zoo on March 25 after it reopened its outdoor exhibits to the public. The Olympic flame is displayed in Iwaki, Japan, on March 25, a day after the 2020 Tokyo Games were postponed. A woman suspected of having coronavirus is helped from her home by emergency medical technicians Robert Zabia, left, and Mike Pareja, in Paterson, New Jersey, on March 24. People practice social distancing as they wait for takeout food at a shopping mall in Bangkok, Thailand, on March 24. Authorities are seen in Madrid, where an ice rink has been converted into a makeshift morgue to cope with the coronavirus fallout. A tourist wears a face mask while visiting the Beijing section of the Great Wall of China on March 24. The section reopened to visitors after being closed for 2 months. People arrive at the South Municipal Cemetery in Madrid to attend the burial of a man who died from the coronavirus. Passengers arrive at Hong Kong International Airport on March 23. Giuseppe Carbari holds Sunday Mass in front of photographs sent in by his congregation members in Giussano, Italy, on March 22. Many religious services are being streamed online so that people can worship while still maintaining their distance from others. People clap from balconies to show their appreciation for healthcare workers in Mumbai, India. A woman attends a Sunday service at the Nairobi Baptist Church in Nairobi, Kenya, on March 22. The service was streamed live on the internet. A Syrian Red Crescent member sprays disinfectant along an alley of the historic Hamidiya Market in Damascus, Syria. People are seen on California's Huntington Beach on March 21. Crowds descended on California beaches, hiking trails and parks over the weekend in open defiance of a state order to shelter in place and avoid close contact with others. A funeral service is held without family members in Bergamo, Italy, on March 21. A member of the Syrian Violet Relief Group disinfects tents at a camp for displaced people in Kafrjala, Syria, on March 21. A doctor examines Juan Vasquez inside a testing tent at St. Barnabas Hospital in New York on March 20. A mass in Rio de Janeiro honors coronavirus victims around the world on March 18. Brazil's Christ the Redeemer statue was lit up with flags and messages of hope and solidarity with countries affected by the pandemic. Medical staff wearing protective suits ride down an escalator at Moscow's Sheremetyevo International Airport on March 18. Hasidic Jewish men take part in a social distancing minyan in New York on March 17. A patient in a biocontainment unit is carried on a stretcher in Rome on March 17. A pedestrian walks a dog through a quiet street in New York on March 17. People gather to collect free face masks in New Delhi on March 17. Dermot Hickey, left, and Philip Vega ask a pedestrian in New York to take their picture on a thinly trafficked Fifth Avenue on March 17. Many streets across the world are much more bare as people distance themselves from others. In the United States, the White House advised people not to gather in groups of more than 10. Students at the Attakai Islamic School wear face masks during a ceremony in Thailand's southern province of Narathiwat on March 17. People wait outside a Woolworth store in Sunbury, Australia on March 17. Australian supermarket chains announced special shopping hours for the elderly and people with disabilities so that they can shop in less crowded aisles. A member of Spain's military emergencies unit carries out a general disinfection at the Malaga airport on March 16. Displaced families near Aten, Syria, attend a workshop aimed at spreading awareness about the coronavirus. French President Emmanuel Macron is seen on a screen in Paris as he announces new coronavirus containment measures on March 16. France has been put on lockdown, and all non-essential outings are outlawed and can draw a fine of up to €135, $148. Macron also promised to support French businesses by guaranteeing €300 billion worth of loans and suspending rent and utility bills owed by small companies. A police officer checks the temperatures of bus passengers at a checkpoint in Manila, Philippines, on March 16. Flowers are stored prior to their destruction at a flower auction in Alzheimer, Netherlands, on March 16. Lower demand due to the coronavirus outbreak is threatening the Dutch horticultural sector, forcing the destruction of products. Body temperatures are scanned as people enter the Buddhist temple Wat Pho in Bangkok, Thailand, on March 13. Two nuns greet neighbors from their balcony in Turin, Italy, on Sunday, March 15. Pope Francis, inside the Church of San Marcello in Rome city center, prays at a famous crucifix that believers claim helped to save Romans from the plague in 1522. Passengers wait for their flights at Marrakesh Airport in Morocco on March 15. U.S. Vice President Mike Pence takes a question during a White House briefing about the coronavirus on March 15. A SeaWorld employee sprays disinfectant in Jakarta, Indonesia, on Saturday, March 14. People wait in line to go through customs at Dallas-Fort Worth International Airport on March 14. Travelers returning from Europe say they were being made to wait for hours at U.S. airports, often in close quarters, as personnel screened them for the coronavirus. Hundreds of people lined up to enter a Costco in Novato, California, on March 14. Many people have been stocking up on food, toilet paper and other items. As a response to panic buying, retailers in the United States and Canada have started limiting the number of toilet paper that customers can buy in one trip. A member of the White House Physician's Office takes a media member's temperature in the White House briefing room on March 14. It was ahead of a news conference with President Donald Trump and Vice President Mike Pence. A nurse in Cremona, Italy, takes a moment in this heartbreaking photo posted to Instagram by photographer Paolo Miranda. Italy's healthcare system has been severely tested by the coronavirus pandemic. Reporters in Arlington, Virginia, sit approximately 4 feet apart during a briefing by Marine Corps Gen. Kenneth F. McKenzie on March 13. People walk past a closed Broadway theater on March 13 after New York canceled all gatherings over 500 people. A Costco customer stands by two shopping carts in Richmond, California, on March 13. A teacher works in an empty classroom at the Pompeu Fabra University in Barcelona, Spain. A woman looks at an empty bread aisle in Antwerp, Belgium, on March 13. Employees of the Greek parliament wear plastic gloves ahead of the swearing-in ceremony for Greek President Katerina Sakellaropoulou. A motorcyclist drives through disinfectant sprayed in Jammu, India, on March 13. Workers prepare to construct an additional building on a hospital on the outskirts of Moscow. Paul Boyer, head equipment manager of the NHL's Detroit Red Wings, wheels out equipment bags in Washington on March 12. The NHL is among the sports leagues that have suspended their seasons. Students leave Glacier Peak High School in Snohomish, Washington, on March 12. Beginning the following day, schools in the Snohomish School District plan to be closed through April 24. and Uber Eats delivery biker stands at a deserted Piazza di Spagna in Rome. People at a railway station in Seoul, South Korea, watch a live broadcast of US President Donald Trump on March 12. Trump announced that, in an effort to slow the spread of the coronavirus, he would sharply restrict travel from more than 24 European countries. Workers in protective suits disinfect Istanbul's Dolmabahce Palace on March 11. A person wearing a face mask walks outside of a shopping mall in Beijing on March 11. Police officers restrained the relative of an inmate outside the Santana jail in Medina, Italy, on March 9. Riots broke out in several Italian jails after visits were suspended to curb the spread of the coronavirus. Medical staff in Wuhan, China, celebrate after all coronavirus patients were discharged from a temporary hospital on March 9. Traders work on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange on March 9. Stocks plummeted as coronavirus worries and an oil price race to the bottom weighed on global financial markets. Rescuers search for victims at the site of a collapsed hotel in Quanzhou, China, on March 8. The hotel was being used as a coronavirus quarantine center. The Grand Princess cruise ship, carrying at least 21 people who tested positive for coronavirus, is seen off the coast of San Francisco on March 8. The ship was being held at sea. Sumo wrestlers attend a tournament in Osaka, Japan, that was being held behind closed doors because of the coronavirus outbreak. A couple rides a bicycle at a park in Seoul, South Korea, on March 7. A volunteer from Blue Sky Rescue uses fumigation equipment to disinfect a residential compound in Beijing on March 5. Airmen from the California National Guard drop coronavirus testing kits down to the Grand Princess cruise ship off the coast of California on March 5. Municipal workers are seen at the Kaaba, inside Mecca's Grand Mosque. Saudi Arabia emptied Islam's holiest site for sterilization over coronavirus fears, an unprecedented move after the kingdom suspended the year-round Umrah pilgrimage. Passengers react as a worker wearing a protective suit disinfects the departure area of a railway station in Hefei, China, on March 4. Teachers at the Nagoya International School in Japan conduct an online class for students staying at home as a precaution against the spread of coronavirus. Soldiers spray disinfectant throughout a shopping street in Seoul. A Muslim worshipper attends a mass prayer against coronavirus in Dakar, Senegal, on March 4. It was after cases were confirmed in the country. People wear face masks in New York's Times Square on March 3. New York reported its first case of coronavirus 2 days earlier. A security guard stands on the Shibuya Sky Observation Deck in Tokyo on March 3. U.S. President Donald Trump, flanked by Vice President Mike Pence, left, and Health and Human Services Secretary Alex Azar, speaks during a meeting with pharmaceutical executives and the White House Coronavirus Task Force on March 2. Throughout the meeting, Trump was hyper-focused on pressing industry leaders in the room for a timeline for a coronavirus vaccine and treatment. But experts at the table, from the administration and the pharmaceutical industry, repeatedly emphasized that a vaccine can't be rushed to market before it's been declared safe for the public. Medical staff stand outside a hospital in Daegu, South Korea, on March 1. Healthcare workers transfer a patient at the Life Care Center in Kirkland, Washington, on March 1. The long-term care facility is linked to confirmed coronavirus cases. British Prime Minister Boris Johnson visits a London laboratory of the Public Health England National Infection Service. Tomoyuki Sugano, a professional baseball player on the Yomiuri Giants, throws a pitch in an empty Tokyo Dome during a preseason game on February 29. Fans have been barred from preseason games to prevent the spread of the coronavirus. Commuters wearing masks make their way to work during morning rush hour at the Shinagawa train station in Tokyo on February 28. Medical staff transport a coronavirus patient within the Red Cross Hospital in Wuhan on February 28. Inter Milan plays Ludogorets in an empty soccer stadium in Milan, Italy, on February 27. The match was ordered to be played behind closed doors as Italian authorities continue to grapple with the coronavirus outbreak. A bank clerk disinfects banknotes in China's Sichuan province on February 26. A child wearing a protective face mask rides on a scooter in an empty area in Beijing. A Catholic devotee wears a face mask as he is sprinkled with ash during Ash Wednesday services in Paranaque, Philippines, on February 26. People disinfect Qom's Massima shrine in Tehran, Iran, on February 25. A worker in Daegu stacks plastic buckets containing medical waste from coronavirus patients on February 24. Paramedics carry a stretcher off an ambulance in Hong Kong on February 23. People attend a professional soccer match in Kobe, Japan, on February 23. To help stop the spread of the novel coronavirus, the soccer club Vissel Kobe told fans not to sing, chant or wave flags in the season opener against Yokohama FC. A team of volunteers disinfects a pedestrian bridge in Bangkok, Thailand. A man rides his bike in Beijing on February 23. Hospital personnel in Cadogno, Italy, carry new beds inside the hospital on February 21. The hospital is hosting some people who have been diagnosed with the novel coronavirus. Doctors look at a CT scan of a lung at a hospital in Xiaogan, China, on February 20. A sales clerk wears a mask as she waits for customers at a hat shop in Beijing on February 18. Small companies that help drive China's economy are worried about how much damage the coronavirus outbreak will cause to business. Buses carrying American passengers arrive at the Haneda Airport in Tokyo on February 17. The passengers were leaving the quarantined Diamond Princess cruise ship to be repatriated to the United States. A medical worker rests at the isolation ward of the Red Cross Hospital in Wuhan on February 16. Authorities watch as the Westerdam cruise ship approaches a port in Sihanoukville, Cambodia, on February 13. Despite having no confirmed cases of coronavirus on board, the Westerdam was refused port by four other Asian countries before being allowed to dock in Cambodia. A worker has his temperature checked on a shuttered commercial street in Beijing on February 12. Beds are made in the Wuhan Sports Center, which has been converted into a temporary hospital. A child rides a scooter past a police officer wearing protective gear outside the Hong Mei House in Hong Kong on February 11. More than 100 people evacuated the housing block after four residents in two different apartments tested positive for the coronavirus. Relatives of quarantined passengers wave at the Diamond Princess cruise ship as it leaves a port in Yokohama, Japan, to dump wastewater and generate potable water. Dozens of people on the ship were infected with coronavirus. The Deanway branch of the County Oak Medical Center is closed amid coronavirus fears in Brighton, England, on February 11. Several locations in and around Brighton were quarantined after a man linked to several coronavirus cases in the United Kingdom came into contact with healthcare workers and members of the public. A police officer, left, wears protective gear as he guards a cordon at the Hong Mei House in Hong Kong on February 11. A worker wears a protective suit as he waits to screen people entering an office building in Beijing on February 10. China's workforce is slowly coming back to work after the coronavirus outbreak forced many parts of the country to extend the Lunar New Year holiday by more than a week. Chinese President Xi Jinping has his temperature checked during an appearance in Beijing on February 10. Photojournalists wearing face masks take photos of a bus carrying passengers after they disembarked from the World Dream cruise ship in Hong Kong on February 9. More than 5,300 people were quarantined on two cruise ships off Hong Kong and Japan. People participating in a Lunar New Year parade in New York City hold signs reading, "Wuhan Stay Strong," on February 9. A shopper walks past empty shelves at a grocery store in Hong Kong on February 9. China's Ministry of Commerce encouraged supermarkets and grocery stores to resume operations as the country's voluntary or mandatory quarantines began to take an economic toll. A worker wearing a protective suit uses a machine to disinfect a business establishment in Shanghai, China, on February 9. Workers in protective gear walk near the Diamond Princess cruise ship docked in Yokohama on February 7. People in Hong Kong attend a vigil February 7 for whistleblower Dr. Li Wenyang. Li, 34, died in Wuhan after contracting the virus while treating a patient. A woman grieves while paying tribute to Li at Li's hospital in Wuhan on February 7. The anthem of the seas cruise ship is seen docked at the Cape Liberty cruise port in Bayonne, New Jersey, on February 7. Passengers were to be screened for coronavirus as a precaution, an official with the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention told CNN. A live installation is displayed by striking members of the Hospital Authority Employees Alliance and other activists at the Hospital Authority building in Hong Kong on February 7. Passengers are seen on the deck of the Diamond Princess cruise ship, docked at the Yokohama port on February 7. Flight attendants wearing face masks make their way through Don Mueang Airport in Bangkok on February 7. Workers check sterile medical gloves at a latex product manufacturer in Nanjing, China, on February 6. A woman wears a protective mask as she shops in a Beijing market on February 6. This aerial photo shows the Lishenshan Hospital that is being built in Wuhan to handle coronavirus patients. A passenger shows a note from the World Dream cruise ship docked at the Kai Tak cruise terminal in Hong Kong on February 5. A mask is seen on a statue in Beijing on February 5. An ambulance stops at a traffic light in front of the Grand Lisboa Hotel in Macau. The virus turned China's gambling mecca into a ghost town. A dog in Beijing wears a makeshift mask constructed from a paper cup. Striking hospital workers in Hong Kong demand the closure of the border with mainland China on February 4. The Diamond Princess cruise ship sits anchored in quarantine off the port of Yokohama on February 4. It arrived a day earlier with passengers feeling ill. A medical worker wearing protective gear waits to take the temperature of people entering Princess Margaret Hospital in Hong Kong on February 4. Medical workers in protective suits help transfer patients to a newly completed field hospital in Wuhan. People wearing protective overalls talk outside a Wuhan hotel housing people in isolation on February 3. A man stands in front of TV screens broadcasting a speech by Hong Kong Chief Executive Carrie Lam on February 3. Lam said the city would shut almost all border control points to the mainland. A colleague sprays disinfectant on a doctor in Wuhan on February 3. Commuters in Tokyo walk past an electric board displaying dismal stock prices on February 3, the first business day after the Chinese New Year. Asia's markets recorded their worst day in years as investors finally got a chance to react to the worsening coronavirus outbreak. Medical workers move a coronavirus patient into an isolation ward at the Second People's Hospital in Fayang, China, on February 1. Children wear plastic bottles as makeshift masks while waiting to check into a flight at the Beijing Capital Airport on January 30. Passengers in Hong Kong wear protective masks as they wait to board a train at Lo Wu Station, near the mainland border, on January 30. A volunteer wearing protective clothing disinfects a street in Qingdao, China, on January 29. Nanning residents line up to buy face masks from a medical appliance store on January 29. Liu Jun, left, a member of a medical team leaving for Wuhan, says goodbye to a loved one in Urumqi, China, on January 28. A charter flight from Wuhan arrives at an airport in Anchorage, Alaska, on January 28. The U.S. government chartered the plane to bring home U.S. citizens and diplomats from the American consulate in Wuhan. South Korean President Moon Jae-in wears a mask to inspect the National Medical Center in Seoul on January 28. Hong Kong Chief Executive Carrie Lam, Center, attends a news conference in Hong Kong on January 28. Lam said China will stop individual travelers to Hong Kong while closing some border checkpoints and restricting flights and train services from the mainland. Workers at an airport in Novosibirsk, Russia, check the temperatures of passengers who arrived from Beijing on January 28. U.S. Health and Human Services Secretary Alex Azar speaks during a news conference about the American public health response. Two residents walk in an empty park in Wuhan on January 27. The city remained on lockdown for a fourth day. A person wears a protective mask, goggles and coat as he stands in a nearly empty street in Beijing on January 26. Medical staff members bring a patient to the Wuhan Red Cross Hospital on January 25. People wear protective masks as they walk under Lunar New Year decorations in Beijing on January 25. Construction workers in Wuhan begin to work on a special hospital to deal with the outbreak on January 24. Dr. Allison Arwady, commissioner of the Chicago Department of Public Health, speaks to reporters on January 24 about a patient in Chicago who had been diagnosed with the coronavirus. the patient was the second in the United States to be diagnosed with the illness. A couple kisses goodbye as they travel for the Lunar New Year holiday in Beijing on January 24. Workers manufacture protective face masks at a factory in China's Hubei province on January 23. Shoppers wear masks in a Wuhan market on January 23. Passengers are checked by a thermography device at an airport in Osaka, Japan, on January 23. People wear masks while shopping for vegetables in Wuhan on January 23. A militia member checks the body temperature of a driver in Wuhan on January 23. Passengers wear masks as they arrive at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport in Manila, Philippines, on January 23. A customer holds boxes of particulate respirators at a pharmacy in Hong Kong on January 23. Passengers wear masks at the high-speed train station in Hong Kong on January 23. A woman rides an electric bicycle in Wuhan on January 22. People in Guangzhou, China, wear protective masks on January 22. People go through a checkpoint in Guangzhou on January 22. Medical staff of Wuhan's Union Hospital attend a gathering on January 22. Health officials hold a news conference in Beijing on January 22. Click subscribe to receive the latest news.